What is up, everyone? My name is Jonathan. Today we are going to be applying a grunge texture to text. And this does not involve downloading any textures or grunge files from Google. This is all done in Adobe Illustrator, so you never have to worry about any licensing or rights to use, etc. So with that, we are just going to jump right in. We're going to change this layer over here to BG, which stands for, you can probably guess, background. And then hit M on your keyboard to create a rectangle. This is going to be our background, all the way over here to intersect. And then we are going to get rid of the stroke, and we're going to change this to like a dark blue. Drag that down here. Bam, something like so. And then we're going to hit Control 2, and this will lock that object on that layer. And we're actually going to lock that layer entirely because it doesn't need to be changed at all. So this next layer is going to be our text layer. And we're just going to hit T on our keyboard to bring up our text. And then we're just going to click out here in the middle, and we're going to type grunge, hit escape, drag this up by hitting shift and alt, drag that up. And we're going to grab, so I have this old school like Bible script text that I like. I think this would look good, and it's a little big, so we'll scale this back down, something like so. And we'll just center this up all the way around. Let's change this to white so everything is much easier to see. And now that that is done, we're going to add a object to this layer just so it's a little easier to grab later if necessary. Because then we can, I guess it doesn't matter. We can just do it on this one. We'll just delete this layer because it's not technically needed. So we'll just stick with this layer here. And now what we want is to use our spray can in Adobe Illustrator, and that is by clicking this little symbol sprayer tool right here, or Shift S, whichever is easier for you. And now when we click on this, it says, please select a symbol from the symbols panel first. So go to your symbols panel, which is over here on the right hand side. If it's not, it is Shift Control F11. I bet it still works. And then so that would be, so now you would spray a symbol, right? So, well, none of these are going to have the desired effect. These are just the stock symbols that come with Adobe Illustrator, but there is a lot more in the libraries right here, symbol libraries menu. So click on that little button right there. And now we are going to go to artistic textures. Click OK. And we're just going to drag this over here and put that in this panel just so it's out of the way. And now you can use whichever one you want. There's some random hatching. I believe there's a splatter. There's a couple of splatter ones. So you could use both, more than one. You could use, let's just put this something like this. And then we can use the other splatter. And then we're going to use this charcoal one right here, and that's kind of a lot finer. Do something like that. All right, and now we're going to, so now, let's see, where was I? Okay, so I've never done that with so many of those textures. So now we need to, we still have our texture selected and nothing else. The text is still in the background. You can see I haven't selected that. And now we're going to go to Object, Expand, because this sees this as like one, like if you had placed an image in here, it doesn't see it as vector objects, or it does, but it's like an image. So we need to expand this so it's all, so there's no, like, see, you can't select any little points. Even if I grab the direct selection tool, it selects the whole thing. So go to Object, Expand, hit OK. And almost there. So now each time the spray can applied each of these textures, now all of those are individual, but they're still not individual pieces. So now we need to go to expand one more time. Click OK. And now we should be good to go there. So now what we're going to do is we're going to copy this texture layer. So hit Control C. And now we're actually going to hide this so it's a little easier to... I was clicking the wrong button. I'm like, why isn't it hiding it? It's the lock button. So now we're going to select our text. So make sure you're just on your selection tool, grab our text layer, and we're going to go over here to your transparency panel. And most people say to create outlines. I'm not sure why, because I have not needed to create outlines in order for this to work. And then by not creating outlines, it keeps the text so that it is editable and you can change the text. Like say you spelled the word wrong or something, you can go back and fix it. So we're going to click make mask, and now it's obviously gone. Well, that's not what we want. So we're going to not clip it, and we're going to click inside the mask here like this. And now we're going to hit Control V and paste the texture that we had copied earlier. And now go back out. Not sure where it went. Where did it go? Just try and reapply that. There we go. So whatever reason, sometimes you just have to click in this and turn the clipping off and turn the clipping back on. Like it just didn't generate that the first time through. And so now we are back out here. And now you have this texture applied to the splatters are a little big. I don't know if I would have done that. I probably would have just done more of the charcoal, but you get the general idea. And now you could delete this, the grunge. This is actually the grunge layer here. So just drag that down, put that in the trash, and you don't need that anymore. And so now this is a completely editable text. It moved, the letters move within the mask. So you should be good to go there. It remains editable, and you can go in and move and adjust the mask properties, the layer on the mask as well. So you can go in here and apply changes to this, like changing the color or whatever. So hopefully this helps somebody. Thank you so much for watching. If you found value in